Welcome back. If you haven't seen my videos before, I'm Ross the Oliver Man, and today I thought we would look at some different white literature. Maybe we can do this every Wednesday, but I figured we'd start with the Workhorse series literature, because that has come up in discussion recently. When you think of the Workhorse literature, you usually think of this piece right here with the front wheel assist on the cover. But there is actually an earlier piece that has a two-wheel drive tractor on the cover, but it does not have the red stripe in the decal yet, as you can see between the two. And they made a few changes on these, but largely the same. And I guess that's a good example of, you know, there are pieces of literature, like I've talked about before, where they might appear similar, but they're not on the inside. And so these appear different, but they're largely the same, I guess. So it kind of goes the other way too. So let's just start with one. Obviously we looked at the cover, the difference. As you open it up, you see it's just a larger version of the two-wheel drive. And if you look at this one, it is the red stripe version. But they also did, it seems like, change it. This looks a little more purple to me than this, maybe, or I don't know, see what you think. But one thing that you may be not able to see on the camera, there's actually like a watermark of the Workhorse here. And there is on this one too, but it's so dark you can't hardly see it. So that's something that's interesting, but largely the text is the same, I believe. There's no difference there. The only difference was the pictures. So if we turn to the next page, at first glance, it looks like everything is the same. But one thing that I noticed that's interesting, if I put them side by side here, in the early piece of literature, they didn't crop this picture enough, and you can see a little bit of a red stripe there. And I believe what this is like a 100, 120, 140, 160, whatever white. And that's why it's got that red on there. And then later they caught that and they cropped it farther so you couldn't see that. So they did recycle a lot of pictures, which sometimes is kind of strange that they would do art department stuff when it seems like it would be just as simple to take a new picture. But in this case, it was as simple as just cutting it down a little in size, and it got rid of that red stripe. Otherwise, they're near identical, and there's nothing changed. It shows the interior of the cab, your tachometer or your computer gauge that shows everything. We'll look at the next page. These are identical. Cummins engines, the white Workhorse and the Cummins diesel engine make for one powerful team. And I haven't found any differences on here. Maybe I'm overlooking something, but you can put it down in the comments if you think I left something out. Otherwise, they are near identical. This page is interesting. As we look, again, at first glance, they look to be near identical. I guess I'll do one side at a time so you can for sure see it. But there is one difference. In the early piece of literature, this caption says the differential lock adds more traction and less wheel slippage by equalizing power to both rear wheels, but it's a picture of the power takeoff lever. So somebody didn't pay attention when they were putting this together. And by the later one, they took a picture of the right thing, the switch that turns the differential lock on. Otherwise, that is the only difference, I believe, between these two pages. They are near identical again. And finally, we look at the last page. Obviously, let's look at the back page first. Two different tractors, and red stripe versus non-red stripe. That's not surprising. This page, though, is all identical except for this one picture at the bottom. And this is an example where they did take a new picture of the guy taking the side panel off of one with the red stripe versus the gray stripe. And it's interesting. It looks to be the same guy. He's wearing a different shirt, and it looks like he got a haircut between the two pictures. But otherwise, same type of stuff. When you look at the back pages, they appear to be the same. The new style piece of literature, though, has the form number on it. And the form number usually tells you the year, you know. Later on in the AGCO ones, it just had a part number like any other part, like a 790. But if you're looking to collect literature, usually the form number will tell you whether they're the same or different. What I thought was interesting is the early one does not appear to have a form number. So I wonder how many of these are actually out there. Usually it's a pretty difficult piece to find. Here lately, I have bought a pack out of Canada that was still wrapped up in the plastic. So I had quite a few of them and ended up selling a lot of them to different collectors who didn't have one. But it doesn't have a form number, and it's got that mistake in it. And I don't know how many of these are actually out there, but it would be interesting to know. You know, maybe they printed a bunch and then ended up destroying them. But anyway, just an interesting thing if you're into Oliver and White literature. Take the time to appreciate what you're looking at, because there are some differences, even though it may appear like a lot of the information's the same. And if you like these videos, I guess we'll continue and look at some more literature over the weeks. I've got about 9 to 10 binderfuls of literature, so we can look at a lot of stuff. And I've got a lot of examples of things that appear to be the same, but they aren't. And that'll be something we can take a look at in the future. So once again, if you like it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss the next one. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.